The historic floods just weeks ago made this impassable. As road crews pick up more and more barricades, more drivers venture down West Dodge Road.
We are going to announce that West Dodge Road is going to be open 3 weeks ahead of schedule.
Governor Pete Ricketts says officially, cars and trucks are now free to go past the 228th Street exit just west of the Elkhorn River. This after crews put in weeks of work.
Probably about four dozen or so people, collectively 10,000 or so man hours in total with zero accidents.
A partnership between the Nebraska Department of Transportation and Hawkins Construction led to this early opening. All parties knew what had to be fixed first.
We lost about a half mile of paving in the eastbound direction, about a half mile, a little more.
Here, the biggest issue was pavement, concrete pavement, panels, column were tipped up. We had to remove those. We crushed that concrete.
With this stretch open, NDOT says drivers won't have to take more detours through areas that weren't built for so much traffic.
Putting traffic through Waterloo when that really wasn't a detour route, but it was stressing Waterloo. Elkhorn area was getting stressed because of Highway 31 up to Highway 64, which is West Maple, to get across the river. So we are just ecstatic that we're finally open and people can get back to normal, at least on one of their commuter routes.
Now, in total, NDOT says it cost them $2.2 million to fix this particular stretch of West Dodge Road leading up to 228th. Across the state, the total figure now for road damage on the roads is around $111 million. But the department understands that fixing these roads, getting them back to normal, really is their top priority. Reporting live in Douglas County, Jose Zozaya for KETV NewsWatch 7.